Absolutely spectacular. And I say this as the geologist and volcanologist. What you are looking at are twin 1,100-foot or 335-meter-high lava fountains produced at the summit of Hawaii's Kilauea Volcano on November 9, 2025. These dual vents were located in the southwestern segment of its summit caldera and erupted a truly stunning amount of lava. During the 297 minutes it continuously erupted for, enough lava was erupted every 5.3 seconds to hypothetically fill a full Olympic-sized swimming pool. Erupting at a rate of 471.94 cubic meters per second, these lava fountains not only created a several hundred foot high lava fall as erupted material flung onto the caldera walls flowed back in, but also resulted in Kilauea's summit caldera becoming an average of 1.5 meters or 4.9 feet shallower. This chart shows just how much shallower Kilauea's summit caldera has gotten since December 2024, a full 75 meters or 246 feet shallower. The time-lapse being shown gives a decent idea of how drastic this change has been since Kilauea's episodic activity began on December 23rd of 2024. But, back to the spectacular lava fountaining that occurred. The sustained lava fountaining began in earnest at 11:19 a.m. on November 9th, erupting at a temperature of 1200 degrees Celsius or 2192 degrees Fahrenheit. Lava fountain heights notably escalated during the next 20 minutes, reaching hundreds of feet into the air. Peak lava fountain heights were then reached around 12:45 p.m., a mere 86 minutes after the start of episode 36. Both vents were tilted by around 10 to 15 degrees to the side, meaning peak lava fountain heights couldn't have reached even taller if not for this tilt. As lava spilled onto the caldera floor, it began piling up, eventually going on to reach 80% of its floor. Bohaihoi lava flows were dominant, with molten rock flowing upwards of 5 miles per hour in some spots, and isolated lava bombs falling a short distance beyond the southwestern caldera rim. Decent numbers of people watched the eruption from multiple viewing points, but activity waned much more rapidly than during many prior eruptive episodes. At 3:38 p.m., the north vent altogether stopped erupting, and 10 minutes after that, the height of the south vent's lava fountains dropped from 1,000 to 500 feet. The southern vent's eruptive rate then slowly declined until it ceased altogether at 4:16 p.m. In total, 8.4 million cubic meters of lava was erupted, marking the highest average effusion rate throughout Kilauea's now 36 and counting eruptive episodes. I want to note that the peak eruptive rate was likely higher during the tallest lava fountaining, as after all, this figure is merely an average. Regardless, it represented this shield volcano's highest rate of lava effusion since 2018. Yet, while 1,100-foot-high lava fountains were quite impressive, they did not rank among Kilauea's top three tallest lava fountains among its 36 eruptive episodes. This chart further illustrates that point. Now, the amount of time people had to wait after the end of episode 35 until episode 36 began was notably long. 22 days occurred between this period, with the prior longest time between two eruptive episodes only being 16 days. While this delay was caused by Kilauea effusing unusually voluminous lava flows for multiple days before lava fountaining began, thus increasing the time magma would need to reach a specific volume, this delay could theoretically signal a new normal. The amount of lava that erupts during these episodes and the amount of time between episodes has progressively increased at a fairly linear rate, and taking into account what happened during the last eruptive episode, I am guessing that episode 37's lava fountaining could begin anywhere from November 21st, 2025 to November 30th of 2025. Meaning, we might be able to watch a livestream of Kilauea's next eruptive episode on Thanksgiving. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member QuakeCatUT for upgrading their membership tier to this channel.